Welcome back to the Countess YouTube channel. And we back with another reaction video. Tonight we're reacting to the 15 times animals mess with the wrong opponent. I mean, don't get me wrong though. You know, I know some people out there that's interested in seeing that shit. So I want to see what's going on. They don't got 12 million views in 7 months. So you feel me? There's other people out here like you that.
Nature would be doing numbers, bro. When it comes to karma, it's not only
members of the human race. It's not the job.
Got
that
here in the title.
I somebody been
talking to shit in you.
I'm definitely dropping the package. Yeah,
man. Imagine if it came face to face with a bigger dog. Why, that is it. Quite so tough then. When here are 15 times animals messed with the wrong opponent.
You too.
Wanna be catching a bitch?
Now it's time for the star topic. I'm not sure if these two guys would be likely to meet up that often. And if they did, it's down to the tiger would have the upper hand.
Showed up.
This alligator is tired or already dead, or the striped guy is one tough dude, and it's payback time for a previous encounter. He looks hungry too, because he's certainly not messing around.
Damn, tiger.
Perhaps he has a family that needs to be fed, or he's worried that another predator will pounce on his giant catch. This tiger isn't leaving anything to chance. He means business. Let's hope it turns out to be worth it. This catch looks a little tough to me. I've never eaten alligator though. What about you? Is it worth it?
I had alligator one time. Come and never was out.
Chewy.
Chewy the bitch. Angry cats versus
chill like Chick-fil-A, don't
always the tough guy. Don't seem to think they'll have the upper hand when it comes to with a cat.
I ain't gonna lie, cats be going jump.
They're wrong.
That's because they got hella balance though.
Between the cat and the dog is
niggas creepy so rich.
Hilarious. The cat is clearly not interested in chatting, and you can tell by that noise it's making.
Yeah.
Unfazed, our hapless canine friend presses on, only to discover that this tough Tom means business. The cat hisses and swipes at him, and the poor guy runs off whimpering loudly while the vicious feline chases him. Let's hope for his sake he got away. Those claws can be nasty. Number 13. Hippo learns lesson from rhino. Typically found wading in water, the dirtier the better. A hippo can be seen playing amongst a small group of rhino in the dark of night. The group seems to be minding their own business when the hippo sets his sight on one of them, starting to chase it around as if wanting to play a game of tag. The rhino isn't having it, and with a nip to its buttocks from the hippo, starts to gallop away. If he thought the game would end there, he was wrong, as the hippo chases after him. Both animals are heavy set, want to withstand a bit of a scrap with the other or an animal of similar build, but the rhino has had enough
and turns
to face the hippo. The hippo immediately opens his mouth wide as if to appear bigger and tougher. In fact, it's almost like a mating ritual between the pair. Clearly sick of being aroused, the rhino butts him with his horn on the behind, sending him scampering off into the distance.
Yeah, that's something I'm
considering. That's hurt. Damn.
Those who feel it can be heard shuffling to themselves.
Caught him real quick. That jump probably hurt. Like, oh, I've been shot.
Number 12.
First of all, he's going to bite down on that bitch. Look, another hippo.
An elephant is filmed waiting in a watering hole infested with hippos. They're everywhere, pretty much surrounding the floor.
Hey, bruh, elephants don't be moving by themselves like that.
Hippos appear to be simply enjoying their daily bath with not a care in the world. In fact, it's probably a ritual they carry out several times a day. I mean, it's not like there's much else to do, surely. One cheeky fellow, obviously a little bored with life and wanting to create some action or entertainment for the others, decides it might be fun to tease the elephant by dragging on its tail. Perhaps he thinks he's funny and the elephant will get the joke, but this time he's picked the wrong elephant. Eventually, the elephant begins to whack him in the face with his swinging tail, but when that doesn't work, things get a little weird. With his patience obviously wearing thin, the elephant kicks the hippo.
God.
This time, he gets the hint.
Damn.
Swept away.
He moved that
the guy moves pretty docile, really. The hippo should be grateful. It could have been a lot worse. Number 11.
Zero
kicks wildebeest.
In the water, though.
In the water.
That's crazy. Hell of a resist.
Through all the water pressure, the moment move.
On his head.
Damn.
And wildebeests are gathered together around the
Hey, can we go back to that?
Most are just quietly gathered the ground below. But all hell breaks. Literally, a juvenile wildebeest is kicked in the head by a drops to the ground in pain. The rest of the pack scatters.
Neat rug.
Oh, me. Neat rug.
Neat rug.
This is something to help the pro wildebeest that is clearly stunned.
Thank you,
Jeff. That's Black Suda right there.
Neither one tough.
Trying to get him up.
Support. Damn.
The whole pack had his
Why does evil wild out like that?
They
only hope the poor wildebeest will be able to come to his senses by nightfall. Number 9. Gorilla sucker punches another unruly gorilla. This footage was taken at the San Diego Zoo back in 2012, and it's gone viral across social media platforms around the globe.
Oh!
Quick bagging and jumping inside their classroom enclosure.
See, you got too close to me, nigga.
For something to do and came to play.
You gotta do that. You gotta do that when you want somebody to get too close to you real quick. Yeah, I'm feeling your presence. Back up.
Throwing him up in the air and rolling him over. It looks to be all in fun, but another gorilla takes offense to the game.
Whether
they got the wrong idea and thought the other gorilla was being a bit rough, I'm unsure. But he was quick to break up the party with a swift punch to his roommate's chops. The crowd laughs, and our gorilla pal appears slightly embarrassed. So too does his young friend, who looks like a sulky, sullen child sitting in the corner. Not content with having his pride hurt in front of spectators, the larger gorilla
his young friend pack leader together. Boom!
Again by the obvious king of the castle. I think he is. More like the party pooper.
What's the choice?
Rhinos give sleeping lions a wake-up call. It was a bit of a surprise that the king of the jungle would be afraid of any other animals, let alone a slow rhino. But hey, life is full of surprises.
He
knows. Two lions are sound asleep in their natural habitat, surrounded by trees, with birds whistling completely at peace, and
no
doubt
you sleep
about their
life. As an animal, shit constantly on your ass.
That's just like Chiron.
Yeah, shit constantly on your ass.
I was right around the corner.
You see how they just walked up on
them. Because of their habitats, the rhino can hardly sleep.
Animals gotta sleep light as a bitch.
Better get your ass up!
From their slumber, the lions are quick to make a hasty getaway as the larger of the two rhinos.
So they got woke up,
it's a big ass rhino, bro.
And the rhino's moving out.
With the lions, the two rhinos.
Niggas, stop!
Look at that rhino horn.
Bro, those niggas be. Bro, is that real, bro?
Yeah, that nigga horn proud.
That nigga body wild. Look at that nigga body.
Catch up.
Yeah.
That conversation. Number 7, electric fence versus goat. Now, if you've ever had an unexpected encounter with an electric fence, you'll know that it is an experience you never want to repeat. As you're attempting to jump over what appears to be a
wire
fence, the vines and the animal separated, you'll discover that it's actually an evil torture device.
You've got to go by it, guaranteed.
If you've never fallen foul of an electric fence, don't even bother experimenting. It's something you will never forget. The same can no doubt be said for this poor goat. Wandering in the paddock one day, perhaps enjoying the sunshine and a wee nibble on the grass, he comes across
a goat. Never going to go to that fence again.
Forget.
Never going to that fence again.
That's not good grass. That's not good grass.
Electric fence with a 5,000-volt kick. The swarms won't help him here. In fact, they might even make matters worse. Tries to take the fence on again. Just imagine getting hooked up in this thing.
My first instinct is to feel
sad. Like trying to jump over that bitch. You get caught on top of that jump.
It's too dead meat.
You can go tonight
and that jump probably yanked him back. Because probably the guy is locked on this jump.
Stay away from the feds.
Oh, he pulled
the fucking board that nigga was.
I said that bitch was sturdy.
Look, that's how fast he
got. Hey, go back, bro. Look how he took off, bro. Hold on.
Goats. This race is a standoff between two goats. Leads for an interesting scram.
Damn,
the larger of the two is quite clearly intimidated by the smaller, which is slightly unusual. Perhaps it's being met on a farmyard playground before. Both have good-sized horns on them, and whilst another paddock pal ignores them and quietly hurts himself, he turns into battle. The smaller goat attacks, the larger retaliates, but at the same time backs away. Is he a little unsure of the situation? Do you want to put some distance between them, or is he just giving himself some fun?
Yeah.
At one point,
he can't get in your way. They just gonna keep doing this.
Yeah, they
keep back on it. Oh, he caught that joint by the neck.
when he came across the tower to
his upward wheel,
perhaps an easy target, was out to such a point he momentarily forgot his intended prey had a safety-conscious gang ready waiting to pound.
No match
for the penguin, the petrel, and his retreat, and preserved a brutal flip of flesh.
Oh,
they
can slap
it. In the wild, it's slowly every animal for himself. When hungry, you can become prey to all manner of other species. It's easy to understand why. Animals go days without meal, so when the opportunity arises, it pays not to be picky.
You shouldn't have been snake.
Beggars can't be choosers. In this footage, you see what appears to be a boy and us together in the dusty desert. Perhaps they're on the lookout for a little something to kill and take back to the hideout to feed their young.
Okay.
Maybe they've been chosen to seek out a meal for the rest of their prime.
Oh,
whatever the case, the bitterest kind sounds like a wild boar. Its squeal can be heard above all
mountains. They move so precisely, bro.
This guy isn't going down.
I know you try to like move away.
Next thing you
try,
the lioness is one precisely in the air, probably held by the boar's large tusks. The pair are shocked by this turn of events and quickly run away. The boar, having won the battle, is leaving another day. And happily trots off in another direction. Number one, when you mess with the beast.
That's
another wild boar makes an appearance.
This time he's on the other end. Come on, man. This
video match up, man. The aggression shown towards it is quite uncalled for.
Damn.
Poor wee guy has done nothing to provoke this vicious assault. Whether the large rhino is busy.
Competitively and get results
to
the
last.
Adjust your budget
and see. At least we know they
have paid
healthy.
He's gonna eat more than his fair share of dinner, and we're not sure. But he removes him from the situation in one swift motion. His victim is lifted in the air before somersaulting and landing on his back in the dirt. Let's hope he doesn't have an ego problem because his mental teeth are
coming. Imagine like when his heroes fail from the ride.
I'm sure it comes as no surprise.
But
that
I mean,
competition
calling
is
like right between his own and
I mean,
precise, bro, precision. Like, they gotta do this shit.
Imagine having to chase, catch, and kill a meal to ensure you're fed each day. For us, a simple shopping trip
no.
Advice. Don't need to fight to the death
of us.
Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.
That's cool. Hey, man. Appreciate y'all watching this video.
Push notifications.
I like that. Don't forget to count up!